Quirindi is a town on the Liverpool Plains in New South Wales, Australia. On the evening of the 9th of January 1905, between 8 and 9 p.m., just after sunset, two ladies were sitting on a veranda in North Street when they witnessed a very peculiar display in the night sky. As they watched, the moon appeared to revolve and a bright star was seen above it immediately afterwards. Both the moon and the star faded to nothing before the moon suddenly reappeared point first, then faded away again, before quickly reappearing curve first. The star came back into view slowly while the moon revolved to the right, then twisted to the left and faded away for the third time. The star remained shining, appearing large and blood red, then it too vanished again. The ladies claimed that in the bright part of the moon they could see what appeared to be a number of black figures leaping about. They called to their neighbours to come and see the strange show. Others also saw it, and one lady was of the opinion that it was a portent of great wars in the near future, while others said the end of the world was nigh. One letter writer opined in the Molong Argus newspaper that one or two stars would often clash with the moon preceding a major war or upheaval of the earth, such as a volcano. They claimed that a friend of theirs had seen a similar exhibition, but this woman saw it at 2 a.m. The letter writer speculated that the cause was a telepathic indication from a massacre of women and children in St. Petersburg, Russia, and what would follow. On Bloody Sunday, the 22nd of January 1905, strikers were attempting to take a petition for the Tsar to the Winter Palace when troops began to intervene to prevent marches reaching the palace. Through the day, strikers and ordinary citizens were caught up in cavalry charges and shootings. At least 96 died, according to official statements, but the death toll could have exceeded 1,000. The people lost faith in the Tsar, and the brutal repression of strikers that followed by year's end, 15,000 executed and 45,000 sent into exile, led inexorably to the Russian Revolution. 8 years after the startling vision, another mysterious event occurred at Quirindi. On the afternoon of the 12th of December 1913, the dense black clouds of a heavy thunderstorm unleashed a deluge over the town. Along with the downpour of water came a less common fall, a rain of small live fish. Several of the fish were still alive when picked up by startled witnesses. It was noted that the eyes of all the fish were bulging. Specimens of the fish were collected and identified as hardy heads, a type of fish common to the Murray and Bogan watersheds. The fish only grow to about 3 inches in length. The ones collected from Quirindi were all about 1 to 1.5 inches long. It was assumed that a waterspout or whirlwind had picked up the small fish from the surface of a nearby river or lake and carried them for some distance before depositing them over the town. Although whirlwinds have been witnessed to suck up many things, the mystery of how they usually only transport one type of creature and nothing else remains. When a vortex was seen to scoop up a lake by a French observer, who witnessed a small lake sucked dry by a whirlwind, it carried away water, fish, plants, and mud from the bottom of the pool. Strange things happen in the dark corners of history.